How I am with Glenn Condron. Glenn Condron is the Senior Program Manager of Visual Studio and DotNet at Microsoft. Yeah, what that means?
Yeah, what does that mean? So program management is difficult to define, I don't know. I work as part of Scott Hunter's program management team, and basically my job is to learn as much about the area that I am kind of assigned, which in my case is lots of server type stuff, cloud native, web APIs, dot containers, like anything to do with taking .NET, running it on a server, is kind of where I have been fitting into lately. And I want to learn everything I can, talk to lots of customers that are trying to do it and do applications in those spaces, and just help define the direction that .NET should be going in whatever space that I am in. That's where I fit as part of that team, trying to like work out how the world makes sense of the world and just work out what features are good and bad for the future.
It's a huge job. It's really
huge. Yeah. There's lots of stuff that happens.
In this new version, you have talked about it in your session. Mm-hmm. In this new version, you have to put a great effort in technologies, not about HTTP. Could you give us a tip about what is gRPC?
Sure. Yeah. My talk here was like ASP.NET Core beyond HTTP, which unfortunately then I talk about gRPC, which is HTTP. But in gRPC's case, it is binary, so it's a non-human readable like communication protocol, and it's a kind of a simple RPC like remote procedure call. Mechanism. So when we look at the customer base of, you know, Windows Communication Foundation, WCF, we look at people using web APIs and HTTP and JSON, there's a lot of people who aren't, they're not really doing REST with HTTP JSON. They just want to like write the get users method and then call the get users method from over here. And there's a lot of stuff associated with a lot of those other technologies that I've just talked about that you don't necessarily need. And so what we think gRPC is a really good fit for kind of getting that fairly simple model for, I need to get the data from this service over here. And we think its sweet spot really is that kind of server to server. I control both sides. I'm happy to share a protocol file, like a protocol definition across these two bits and do a bunch of code gen. That's really where we think its sweet spot is. If you're trying to do like, you know, I'm going to publish this API to everybody in the world, and I'm going to have 50 different people in their own technology stacks implement clients for this API or consume my data, JSON is probably, or HTTP JSON is probably a lot better. It's a lot more ubiquitous. But gRPC could be used for that, but we think it's probably better to use HTTP and JSON.
So it's the future, but maybe not the single way.
Yeah, that's right. So I think a lot of this is just give you more options for more places. So if you find yourself in that server-to-server space, you think it's okay, you control kind of both sides, you want something pretty efficient, gRPC is great. And you don't necessarily need the stuff that you're going to get from, say, a web API with HTTP and JSON. We think that that's good. You don't have to use it for everything. It's not that, you know, gRPC replaces everything and it's just strictly better. It's not the case in any way, shape, or form. It's just another tool for when the right situations arrive, you can reach for it. And if you understand just enough gRPC for when it might be interesting, and then if you ever hit that situation, use it. And then call life good, right? Like you have gRPC, you could do a web API, you could do some signaler, like there's many different methods for communication, and you pick the right tool for the right job, and each have their kind of strengths and weaknesses, which we try not to be shy about telling you what they are if you want to.
So for example, in the world of microservices, do you see maybe using gRPC to communicate in microservices?
Yeah, one of the big ways we want to talk about gRPC is things like perhaps you have, for example, if you're in one of the patterns that people use when building microservices, kind of this backend for your frontend pattern, where you might make an API gateway or a single API for, say, a single frontend, and then you, behind that facade, you call a bunch of other services or you do a bunch of stuff. And we think that for a lot of that inside stuff, gRPC is great. You control all the sides, it seems it's binary, it's efficient, it seems nice, right? But then for the thing that's going out over the internet potentially, maybe over to your mobile app or something like that, you could use gRPC, but HTTP and JSON is probably easier. And so we're thinking that's where we're focusing on for our scenarios, and it seems to be that that's where most of the gRPC community are as well, where it's kind of inside the firewall communication. And when you're going to go outside the firewall, you switch to you know, HTTP or JSON and things like that. Or maybe you reverse proxy it. Some people are doing things where they will implement a proxy, which is HTTP and JSON here, and then it converts it to gRPC over here, right? And even doing things like that potentially. But so we don't really know if the gRPC community at large is going to go after that outside the firewall scenario. At the moment, we're just talking about it in, and then we'll see where everything leads.
Yeah, and for a developer as me, in this new version, what do you feel? What I found is something that will be excited for me. Say that point, developers around the world have feel vibrant about that point. And any point that you have feel this way?
Something that I'm excited about as a developer for this thing. So, there's a new thing called Worker that I talk about, and I think. We see in keynotes and stuff, Scott Hunter's been talking about it, where you can do file new worker and run it as a Windows service or a systemd thing or in a container or anything like that. That is really exciting to me, and it's super exciting to me because it's been a long time coming. Like, we've had the idea that is eventually turned into how we could ship this worker for a long time, and we've been slowly evolving the stack and like factoring everything better and decoupling things that needed to be decoupling till we can get to this world where you can take a lot of the core goodness that is ASP.NET Core today, like configuration, DI, like all of those things that you, if you go make a new ASP.NET Core app, people think of, and just give them to everything in .NET. So there's a talk from Build with me and James from Xamarin, where we show, you know, Xamarin Forms with the host builder and config and DI and everything. It feels just like an ASP.NET Core app, but it's a Xamarin Forms app on a mobile phone. Like, that's really amazing to me. Like, I love this, like, we build this common thing and it just works everywhere and it's great, and you can use it all over the place, and that's exciting to me, and partly because it's been a long time that we've been working towards trying to get this thing in.
I would like to thank you about being here and for your time. Thank you, and see you in the next interview. Thank you.